Hello, and welcome to the TI Precision Labs Switches and Multiplexers series. In this video, we will discuss how to prevent crosstalk and improve system reliability with injection current control. We will start by identifying an injected current event and discuss the impact this may have on your system. Finally, we will address the benefits of injection current control. An injected current event occurs when current is injected into the pin of a disabled signal path and raises the node voltage above the supply voltage. In a device with no control circuitry, the internal protection diode will be forward biased and the supply rail voltage will be affected. Because the on resistance of the enabled FET switch is impacted by the change in the supply rail, an error in the output signal voltage can be expected. In this example, S2 is the enabled signal path that is conducting a signal from S2 pin to the D pin. Because there is an injected current at the disabled S1 pin, the voltage at that pin increases above the supply voltage, and the ESD protection diode is forward biased, therefore shifting the power supply rail. This shift in supply voltage alters the R-on of the internal FET switches, causing a delta V error on the output at the D pin. To avoid the complications of added external protection to your system, some switches have internal injection current control that protects your system and ensures a stable output signal. When the internal circuitry detects a voltage above supply at a disabled signal path, the control circuitry for that particular pin is enabled. The injection current control circuitry is independently controlled for each source or drain pin. This internal circuitry shunts the injected current to ground, protecting the supply rail and enabled signal path. It is important to follow the recommended operating conditions when designing a system with a device with injection current control. For example, this MUX tolerates up to plus or minus 50 milliamps of current injected into a disabled path. The total current injected into all off switches must be within plus or minus 100 milliamps. Limiting the injected current in a switch with injection current control is as simple as adding a series limiting resistor to the disabled signal paths. The limiting resistor can be calculated using Ohm's law. The resistance must be greater than or equal to the expected voltage at the input of the disabled channel divided by the maximum injected current rating. Additional characteristics can be found in a device with injection current control, such as the maximum shift in output voltage at the specified test conditions. Injected currents can come from various sources depending on the application. Harsh environments and applications with long cabling, such as in factory automation and automotive systems, may be susceptible to injected currents from switching or transient events. Other self-contained systems can also be subject to injected current if the input signal is coming from various sensors or current sources. Without injection current control, a system has the potential to be backpowered through the forward-biased ESD protection diodes. During an injected current event, error in the output signal may be observed. This undesired change in the output can cause issues related to false trigger events and incorrect measurement readings, potentially compromising the accuracy and reliability of the system. Switches with injection current control do not have any internal diode paths to the supply pin, simplifying your system design and eliminating the risk of backpowering the supply rail. To protect a device without injection current control from injected current events, multiple components need to be added to the system, increasing cost and size of the system. A network of diodes and passive components is needed at every input of the device that is vulnerable to injected current. In addition, an external voltage regulator is needed at the power supply rail to ensure supply rail stability. Implementing a switch with injection current control eliminates the need for these external diode resistor networks. In this video, you learned how to prevent crosstalk and simplify your circuit design using switches with injection current control. Thank you for watching. To find more switches and multiplexers, technical resources, and search products, please visit ti.com/switches.